So this is a 1 kilogram pair of ankle weights, or is it 2 kilograms? 2 kilograms, 1 kilogram each, I guess. And I hold it out in this way to get a little bit more of a stretch in my lower back and also to facilitate coming forward, increasing the flexion through the ankles. So I try to bring my shoulder pit as close as possible to the kneecap, and holding it in this fashion, I push my triceps into my knees. So this is really good. This little box here with the ankle weights facilitates that. So this way I can come forward to the full passive range of my ankles. You'll notice that my feet are pointing straight forward. And the purpose of this exercise is to effectively relax the muscle running up along the shin, because that tends to get quite tight. Last week I had to wear smart shoes. I always wear flat shoes or barefoot. So that was not great for my legs. Then we've got an 8 kilogram kettlebell. Same thing really, just a little more intense. So holding it out, just got to make sure that I don't hyperextend my elbows, or like so. So this way I can put the weight into my heels and allow the kettlebell to pull down and out. So this is basically a stretch for my lower back. Although the whole time spent here is something of a stretch or relaxation of the lower back. So this mug is filled with boiling water with lime in it. You can have lime's good, lemon's good, or even some apple cider vinegar. But lime or lemon are preferable. So I feel a bit more tension through here than here, but otherwise it's fairly comfortable. My weight seems to tend a little bit more to my right, so I'm consciously distributing it evenly. It's a long-standing issue on my left side. It's something I suspect around the left hip that restricts me, and there's routinely more resistance through the left shin and ankle than on the right. It's not bad. When I first started doing this, my shins used to really burn. But I suppose they've become conditioned. and working out what I need to do to hold this position with the minimum effort. So I'm actually tilting a bit to my left in a bid to get the left to release a bit. Something I find helps a little. A bit primitive, a bit crude, but it seems to work. You can see here. Hit away at the muscle, not too hard, just as much as the masseur would, Swedish masseur. Helps a bit. Actually, it's quite good. So the thing you'll notice about this position is it's not a position for bearing weight, really. This is a position for, I mean, it's active because I'm squatting, but it's really a relaxed squat. Very different from if I were lifting weights. Because you don't, although you need to have great range of motion through your ankles, like dorsiflexion, you do not. You really can't generate the power from this position. You have to be a bit wider. So this is more a position for meditating, for identifying where weaknesses are, that sort of thing. Now that I've gone through the, I don't know how long I've been here, it's pretty comfortable. Because my feet are quite, well, fairly narrow as far as these things go, you notice my knees are point of turning out. I'll bring them in. And the weight is more, because I'm pushing my knees out, basically abducting the femurs, the weight is more to the outside of my feet. But given the positioning of my feet, that's to be expected. I feel that I'm being pulled around this way. So, probably need to exaggerate it over me to compensate and to identify what's going on in the wrist, maybe my lower back, to understand what's twisting my torso around to the right. Finished. So I can hang out here for a while. It's a good way to start the day. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is actually bring my feet all the way in and tap tight. This is a stretch, I guess, for the outer glutes. And basically the outside of the hip and extending somewhat to the top part of the outside of the leg. And you may also feel it through your lower back. This, of course, is assuming that you can get into the position, but if you can, it's pretty beneficial. I'm recording. So, going to my heels. Knees together, ankles together. So this makes it a little easier. Now I can really bring my knees forward over the top of my ankles. There's no external rotation happening here, so it's right over the front of the top. Really no option for external rotation. This is considerably harder than previous position. And that is considerably harder than having your feet turned out and your heels even a little wider. But it's pretty good. And now, this position, with my feet a little wider, is quite easy. You notice my feet are basically pointing forward, which means I have to externally rotate. I have to use my external rotators. Whereas if I turn my feet out here, that's an easier position. stretch. That's about it. Thanks for watching.